today's episode, we learn how we can convert the wastewater discharge from RO purifiers into green gold. Yes, it's really simple to build and maintain a simple, low-cost hydroponic system to grow your greens at home. You will be surprised to see how effective this is. Coming up. Here's the list of things required for the frame. A 3 to 4 feet long and a 3 inch caliber PVC pipe. Two elbows of 3 inch for this pipe and some threading or plumbing tape. I'm going to show you how to build this setup in a kitchen window. You can use your own custom length of the pipe based on where you're going to build it. Next, you need a power drill and a hole saw of about 1 inch if you're using 1 inch net pots. These net pots are hydroponic baskets wherein we plant the seeds. We're going to plant 15 hydroponic baskets into this pipe. So, we're marking the same on the pipe after measuring to divide the space equally. You need a hole saw of the same circumference as the middle of the basket itself. We need to make sure that the basket is only about halfway into the insert we are about to make. Once done with all the 15 inserts, let's now put some threading tape at the edges and stick two elbows in place. You can also purchase pipe head closers, but I found elbows to be cheaper and much more convenient. Stick around towards the end of the video and you'll know the reason behind this. That is it. Our setup is ready. All you need is some clay pebbles, coco peat or peat moss, and these plastic net pots. These are actually very cheap to purchase online. You can check links to purchase these in description if you're interested. Let us get into planting the seeds now. First, let's insert the net pots into these slots. Let's drop 3 to 4 clay pebbles into each basket. These pebbles not only give easy access to the roots into the water, but also maintain the humidity and help in keeping the pH of water in check. Now, let us add some coco peat in each basket. Now we can start sowing the seeds. We are planting spinach, coriander or cilantro, and amaranthus seeds. Once the seeds are dropped, let us now install the frame in place on the kitchen window. Any place with indirect sunlight and good ventilation will do. Make sure that the setup is perfectly horizontal so that the water does not flow out to one side. I'm just putting a zip tie on mine to hold it in place. Now spray some water collected from the RO discharge outlet using a bottle sprayer till the coco peat is nicely moist. Within 5 to 6 days, you can see the seeds have sprouted and are 2 to 3 inches long. Amaranthus is doing very well, as you can see. A week after the setup was put in place, start checking for the signs of roots underneath the baskets. They are extremely delicate, so be careful not to damage these. Once you spot the roots, you are ready to start the hydroponics. Now, let us get our nutrient solution ready. Before we start preparing nutrient solution, you need to know few basics of RO water purifier. We all have this RO water purifier installed in our homes. The main drawback of this is excessive water wastage. These RO purifiers or reverse osmosis purifiers use membrane technology to filter dissolved impurities. The impure water is filtered out and is often called the wastewater or reject water. Because of the high level of impurities and dissolved solids, this reject water is not fit for drinking. But this water can be used for watering your plants. So, to make the nutrient solution, all we need is 1.5 liters of water collected from the RO purifier discharge outlet. You will need to add about 1.5 ml of nitrogen, 1.5 ml of phosphorus, and finally 1.5 ml of potassium solutions to the water. These liquids are easily available from many online sellers or even in garden store. If you want to make a completely organic hydroponic nutrient solution, you can use about 1:50 dilution compost tea made out of organic fertilizers like decomposed cow dung or vermicompost. We'll discuss this in detail in some other episode. Well, Now give it a good mix and pour it into the elbow opening of the pipe so it's evenly spread out. We'll also drop a small air stone connected to an air pump into the pipe to maintain the oxygen level of the solution. And then cover the open outlets of the elbows with some paper cups to avoid insects or dust getting in. Here is the progress after 2 weeks. As you can see, the leaves are healthy and green with absolutely no disease. This is one of the major advantages of using hydroponic system for growing your greens. Now let's look at the roots. The roots have grown a lot too and appear absolutely healthy. So this is working as expected. After 2 weeks, it's time to change the water solution, and this is where I feel the elbows make it so much easier to change the water. No need to remove the setup from place. Simply place a bucket under one of the openings and gently turn or rotate the pipe around. The water should flow out into the bucket and you're done. Prepare the same solution as earlier and then pour it back in. This is what our plants are looking after 3 weeks now. The spinach has reached the stage of harvesting. And finally, this is what our beautiful plants are looking like after the 4th week of sowing. We have beautiful spinach ready to be harvested. You can see the coriander leaves too. To harvest, all you need to do is snip the leaves using a small scissor. You can expect more leaves to regrow every time you harvest, as the root system is now healthy and well grown to support the leaf growth. So there you have it, folks. Please like, share and comment below with your feedback and queries. Happy gardening!